All right. Hello, everybody. My name is Chris McMeeking. I'm a senior software engineer here at DQ Systems, and I am here today to talk to you about iOS accessibility, in particular, a cool tool in the iOS keychain toolchain that helps you do accessibility stuff and explore the accessibility properties of your application. One of the things that frustrates me about the iOS environment is how difficult it is to test on a device, to keep devices set up and manage your profiles and your development stuff, and you never know when that tool chain is going to break and your team agent has to go in and accept some new updated agreement, and how long is it going to be until you can test on a device again. And it's very frustrating. So I find myself testing on the simulator a lot, but when you're testing on the simulator, you do not have access to VoiceOver or the other assistive technologies on the device. And so I find myself exploring the accessibility of my app using the Accessibility Inspector a lot. And so what I'm going to talk today is about how you can use the Accessibility Inspector not only to help you make more accessible VoiceOver applications, but also it helps you explore the accessibility, all of the accessibility properties that are available for other assistive technologies such as switch control, braille boards, alternative input devices, and all of that. You can see all of the properties at once, whereas VoiceOver really only cares about a subset of those properties. So this is going to help you explore all of that information in one place and really is a more valuable tool for developers than VoiceOver. You should always test with VoiceOver as a part of your tool chain. But I use VoiceOver at the end of that process and use the Accessibility Inspector throughout that process. And so what we're going to do is we're going to bring up Xcode. We're going to go to Open Developer Tool, and we are going to start the Accessibility Inspector. This is the Accessibility Inspector. Let me bring back up my simulator. So I have my simulator here. Notice we have our DQ University for iOS app running. This is an application that just demos simple accessibility APIs and how you can do things poorly and how you can do things well. And then notice over here, the Accessibility Inspector, I can connect it to a lot of different processes. I am going to connect it to my iOS simulator. And when you connect it, you can run it in against your MacBook Pro, but what's going to happen is you're going to get different types of feedback. So it's going to treat these objects as desktop objects. Rather than notice when I go into the simulator, I get a much simpler view. And so basically what we're doing is in the Accessibility Inspector, this is in desktop mode. So it's treating the simulator like a desktop app, which in itself is valuable. If you're a desktop application developer, the Accessibility Inspector is still a valuable tool. But we are concerned about iOS today, and this is the simpler iOS view of those accessibility properties. And so notice I have this target icon up here, and what we can do is we can go and we can highlight certain things. We can see the accessibility information. So let's go into one of these stories here. Let's go to conflicting traits. This one's interesting. And notice I'm driving the UI with this, right? Much like you can drive the UI with VoiceOver, I can drive my UI with this. I can click on things, and then so right now I have this selected. So I have targeted this menu button. And I can go in and I can target new things, or I can go in here and I can click on this just like so, but you have to click twice, right? So if I want to activate my conflicting traits tab here with the Accessibility Inspector, I click on it once. So now it's the thing that's highlighted. Notice focus isn't updating. And then I click on it again, and we have activated that control, and that same activation is available over here. Notice I can perform this activation over here. So if you click twice on the same control, you're doing the basic activation. And I don't have to follow that. I can still swipe once we don't have this focus, this target thing, if that's not selected, we can just swipe back and forth just like our iOS device is running normally. The cool thing to point out here is that the Accessibility Inspector, when in this targeting mode, is going to focus the same thing that VoiceOver focuses. So any of these controls, as I'm cruising my mouse over these controls, it's just like you were interacting with VoiceOver on a device, running your finger over the application, doing that VoiceOver focus. It's going to focus the same things. You're going to get the same navigation as you're going to in VoiceOver. And then what we can do is we can select one of these and we can go in and we can see interesting things about it, right? So we can see the label here. We have the label is conflicting traits. Notice this case is just the text, right? It has no value. A text control having a value doesn't really make sense. And it has the trait of header. The trait of header is a cool trait. It's going to mark it as a navigation landmark and announce as a header. So we can see that we could get information from this tool about the accessibility of our application. And so one of the things I said was that each of these stories is designed to demo a unique accessibility violation that you can run across, right? And so let's see if we can use the accessibility inspector to find violations, right? Button and link example, this is another just kind of static text example. Label, button, and link, trait, static text. The trait of static text doesn't really do anything for UI labels. They're always static text, but it's a default trait on that value. So this is all up to snuff. This is all what we'd expect. Visit this site. Let's take a look at this. Visit this site. Label, visit this site. Traits, button, and link. So here we have an accessibility violation. You would not expect the traits of button and link to be on the same control. What you really want is just to have the trait of link on this control. So what's going to happen is a link in iOS, I think, is pretty well defined as anything that you click on that's going to take you out of the context of your current running application. That's a very important bit of information to communicate to a VoiceOver user, that the application is going to change context and take them out of the current thing, right? Because it's not like desktop where if you click it, you can open up a new window and you're still in the same context. In mobile, when you click on a link, a completely new application opens. And that's really important information to share. And the fact that it's a button in this case is redundant, right? A link is a special type of button. And so when VoiceOver announces this, what it's going to say is, visit this site, button, link, right? We don't need the announcement of button. We just need the announcement of link. And so those two traits, you should just never use those two traits together. Anytime you want to say button and link, you always just want to say link. And so down here, notice that we have this other bit of information, traits, link. So that button's accessible, and we've used the accessibility inspector to identify that, okay? So now, let's point out another cool feature of the accessibility inspector, and that is the ability to run audits. We can do automated accessibility analysis. And so we bring up the page that we want. We're already connected to the simulator, and we can run an audit on this. And so this is cool. It helps you identify things. But I will warn you that actually I think pretty much all of these announcements are false positives in this case. So take the violations that you see with a grain of salt. But let's confirm that, right? So when we change this, notice that the audit thing that we have here is dynamic font sizes are unsupported, right? So it's claiming that dynamic font sizes are not supported. And notice when we go over here, we scan this, let's update our font sizes. And so when we go here, notice that our font sizes are actually updating. Everything is working the way we would expect in terms of dynamic font sizing. So the audit tool is cool. It's a good tool to use, but you've got to take its output with a grain of salt and make sure that you actually do that confirmation that is actually that those are actually issues, right? And actually, one of the things that tools that I develop is automated tools that do the same things that do not have these false positives, and you should absolutely look into a test for iOS. But we are talking about the accessibility inspector, and I think that's pretty much all I had to share about it. I mean, it's a cool tool. You can use it to test a lot of things. I mean, even just the fact that you can test this dynamic type thing and control it in here without having to go and change the device on iOS. It's always been frustrating for me to test iOS dynamic type and all of these other accessibility issues that you can spot just by using this information, and the fact that, again, it's all confined within the realms of the simulator. And you can run this against a device. If you have a device connected, you can absolutely run it and connect it to a device, which is cool. But I think it's real valuable to a developer when you have somebody on your user experience side who's saying, hey, there is an accessibility issue on this control. You can come in and see the accessibility properties of those controls and see why it is behaving the way it's behaving. Because for a developer, I think the why part of that equation is the most important part of that equation. And that is the information that the accessibility inspector gets you. And so that is all I have today. Be sure to check out my other videos. This is actually the first one in the iOS line, but I have a couple of Android videos done, and there will be more iOS and Android videos to come. We're on about a video every other week pace right now. So thank you for listening, and have a good day.